Depressed people of Reddit who have been so depressed that they couldn't get out of bed and completely stopped taking care of themselves. How did you overcome this and got back to engaging with life?
I used to hate the fact that I wasn't doing anything. Even taking care of myself. Slowly I resigned to the fact that I am not going to do anything cause I don't have the mental capacity for that. Once I did that, I stopped caring and worrying about it. That really helped cause these thoughts were no longer in my brain. Which meant I had more brain capacity to start doing small things again. Still haven't become the best version of myself, but I am getting there one task at a time. And not putting any pressure on myself is really helping. Hopefully by the end of this year, I will be taking great care of my hygiene and be doing okay. I started going for long walks all day every day and eventually got a job which I attended religiously. In a way my depression was situational, so changes to the situation alleviated it. I'd argue the depression is still there, it's just masked by the necessity of work and some self-imposed obligations and responsibilities. The bad side, pf, this is now work is my panacea and I'm a real workaholic, to the detriment of everything else in life. But given that hasn't made me hopelessly depressed, it's still an improvement. It's not a cure. I rarely feel content, satisfied, etc. I just seldom feel like ending it all, and it's less severe when that does crop up. I wouldn't say completely, I still ate once a day almost every day, and showered weekly. But I was in bed any moment I could get away with it. Medication. That took a while too, since I literally couldn't get out of bed for anything that I didn't feel absolutely necessary. Leaving the room, let alone the house, was a crazy struggle. I did it though to keep going to work, part-time just once a week, rest I was doing remote, and to not be a burden to my family. Eventually, on one of those days out, I made my way to the clinic. Talking with the doctor and drugs allowed me enough clarity of mind to be able to at least start forcing myself to do things. They didn't fix me, but the catatonic mentally driven bed rest could be stopped. I just wait till I get so miserable that I start to be ashamed of myself. Then I get back to exercising, biking, reading, playing music, studying, etc. until I get hit again, and wait for the rock bottom. I kind of like that, to be honest. Suffering is good, as long as I don't hurt anyone. Makes me reflect on life in a deep way. Then I take those thoughts and apply them when I get better. I accepted the fact that I'll be sad for the rest of my life. Life is shitty. I can't be happy. And since then I'm essentially Dr. House. Cold, cynical, sociopathic, not as funny though. To be honest, I wouldn't have it any other way. Takes a long time. There came a point where I knew I needed help or I wasn't going to be around much longer. I wasn't eating, wasn't sleeping, I was just going through the motions. I finally went to the doctor. Got on meds, therapy, a diet. Slowly but surely things started coming back. It's little things at first, but it got more over time. I wasn't tired all the time, I started feeling interest in things again. I gained weight. I had less panic attacks and random fits of crying. I had and still have bad days. And it takes time and work. But the first step is being ready to make that call. Fluoxetine, and the ability to reconnect with my friends at my own pace without feeling left out or too isolated. This was at the start of the pandemic, and everyone finally understood the pain and fear I felt on a daily basis when their lives were overturned, so it was easier to integrate back with them. Also got lucky with the stock rallies and made enough to not feel financially chained by capitalism, for the short term anyways. I strongly suggest coffee. Seriously, you just have to start somewhere, even if it's just one thing a day, and add one thing to that until eventually your routine is functioning again and then the cycle starts over. Overcome? Dude, I'm still in it. I was gonna vent like I did on another post on here, then I read the end and said, for fuck's sake, this doesn't flow properly, even forget it. Mum's support and heavy medication, to put it simply. Antidepressants, weed, finding what little motivation I have to further improve my current situation. Just need to keep my mind stimulated to have interest in anything. This happened to me last year. I lived a busy, fairly normal life, corporate job, child and husband. One day I started to feel ridiculously anxious at work and it spiraled into depression, nothing I had experienced before. I couldn't get out of bed, cried for no reason, saw zero joy or hope in life / the world and felt all round miserable. The only thing that helped me was starting a care plan with a psychologist, where we focused on positive psychology and self-care. Talking through what was going on in my head and learning strategies to overcome it, mental, physical, everything, was amazing. It is a constant effort to keep from returning to that place, but I actually enjoy what is now known to me as self-care, exercise, which for me is just an afternoon endorphin bringing walk, challenging / questioning negative self-talk, being more engaged in my home life, starting hobbies again and doing the things I enjoy, regardless of how minimal or silly they are, like watching funny videos, etc. It has actually helped me cope with what was probably years of repressed trauma I just had never dealt with, and I am finding my relationships with others just get better and better as become more me rather than this personality that was born from a toxic environment and a need to cope. I feel less like a reflection of my parents' challenges and more like my own self, with my own future that could go any way. Sounds a bit lame, but it's been massive for me and, well, I'm not crying in bed anymore. I got a plant and I stayed committed to take care of it, I even gave it a name. The more it grew, the more motivated I felt. Whenever things got heavier, I talked to it and let the feelings go. Oddly enough, it actually helped me a lot. After a few weeks, I was able to get out of bed and start doing some things. Listening to calm, instrumental music also helped, and I tried not to rush myself to get better, otherwise I would get really anxious and make things worse. After days without feeling the need to be on bed all day, I forced myself to get to know people on the internet and in games, and even though it was something quite new to me, it was good and I ended up liking it a lot. My dog started yelling at me because she was bored. You just have to. I remember I was driving and the car in front of me ran over a squirrel and its lower half was completely gone, but it was still alive and struggling. I am sure it still had hope that everything will get better. Like most of us. The reality is we are all like that, but we evolved to live. Just do it. Obligation. Taking life day by day, living in the present moment, realizing that depressive thoughts telling you you're useless, worthless, etc. are just thoughts, not reality. You don't have to engage with them, meditation helps a huge amount with this. Also, writing a gratitude diary, it reminds you that even little things like having your own bed or having food in the fridge or whatever are things to be grateful for. Stop pressuring yourself to be happy and set more realistic goals, even if it's just having a shower or a hot meal. Everything is an achievement when it feels like you're weighted down with bricks constantly. Stop comparing yourself to others and realize that you have an illness and you can't help it, no different to if you were physically ill. Doing anything that takes you out of the depressed / helpless / worthless narrative and pushes you to see life a bit more realistically, it's not all sunshine and rainbows, but there are things to be happy about and there are good things in the world. I simply accepted that my emotions are like everything else in the universe and are in a constant state of change, so there's no reason to dwell on any of them. Wait, overcome? What the hell is that? Told myself my unhealthy habits would absolutely destroy me and give me pain. Inspired by the god-awful stomach pains I got from not eating and the indigestion problems from starvation. If I don't make a habit of drinking water, I'm more likely to get kidney stones, which apparently really fucking hurt. If I don't brush my teeth, they will fall out of my gums. I can't think of any more RN, but you get the idea. Also, I made a playlist of happy and nice songs. They make me feel a bit better. Having the curtains open so I can see the sun is also good for me. The sunlight makes me real happy and reminds me of better days. Hope things go well for you, you/maximum cover smile. A great video that may or may not help depending on who you are is 7 Ways to Maximize Misery by CPG Gray. The video tells you many things that people do that perpetuate depression, such as staying demotivated, losing sunlight, sleep and more. While it could act as a downer to some, the feeling you have realizing that you do everything he says is one that sparks wanting to do something. Start simple, you don't rush getting out of the cycle, and every little thing like opening the curtains and getting sunlight or having a shower or going for a walk adds up. A pet that forces you to take care of them, take them for a walk and act as general motivation to do something meaningful is a great step if you can afford it. When you're ready, try to learn something or do something big, but stay comfortable and don't set your standards unachievably high. Set the bar for success attainable within a short amount of time and with decent work and extend the bar each time you reach it, so you always have the satisfaction of achievement. To finish with, I'm not a professional, I'm a random Redditor just trying to pitch in something to hopefully help someone. Try to have a good life, perpetuating sadness is an unhealthy lifestyle, but don't get discouraged if it feels like your progress is slow, because it speeds up, and it's worth it. We'll be right back.